flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Entertain a motion to declare open meeting.
So moved.
Second?
Second.
The first and second, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed nay. Motion carries 6-0. Open Meetings Act is posted on the door back there on the sidewalk. Care to read it? Roll call, Deb.
Yes.
Dr. Thor.
Present.
Chance.
Yes.
Tim.
Yes.
Wyatt.
Yep.
Myself here. All counted. Number six, approve the agenda. We've got a couple changes. We're going to drop number 10. And not replace it.
There's no policy review.
No policy review. And then number 22, ELA materials, the price has changed. So we'll table that until next month. So then we'll move on to the, entertain a motion to approve the agenda with those changes.
Excellent, Kelly.
And first and second, to approve the agenda with so said changes. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed nay. Motion carries 6-0. Consent agenda, start with minutes of last month. Anybody has any questions or remarks or changes, we'll move on to the financial reports.
Just short of 300,000 property tax revenue for the county today. So that's nice. That's some significant revenue. Just 1 month, but well, that'll be claims, but we do not have ESU in our claims this month, so that's our claims are low. So that'll be a little more significant for well, 2 months at ESU.
Do any more payments to facility advocates coming out?
Yes, we got more payments.
Is that to be like a monthly?
They've been billing that out. I think we've received our third $400,000 request. So we may have one more coming midsummer. Facility advocates.
Yes.
We just got their third request.
Yes, 3 of 9, which we have not.
Three known. Of nine.
Four.
Okay.
4 of 9, I think, is waiting to be paid.
But there's two of them together equal 400,000.
Yes.
How many of them are of those nine are this year? Should be about nine, because well,
I
for
think
them, we'll, but then we'll borrow
yeah,
some of that from the bank.
Yes, I think we'll have one more big one. Were they here today, Kel?
Yes, right? They were.
Yeah. Model Electric's been doing quite a bit of work up on the roof, so they've been doing quite a bit of prep work. They might even get in the Pirate Gym as early as this month yet to do what work they need to do inside there. So they've been working really somewhat steadily since the contract was approved. Of course, they've been asking for money steadily.
No equipment showed up. questions on that? If not, we'll go to the claims. Do you have all the copiers, all three of them?
Yes.
Yeah, there's no more questions. I'll entertain a motion to approve the consent agenda.
I'll make a motion to approve the consent agenda.
Second.
Second.
The first and second, and all in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed nay. Motion carries 6-0. Number eight, student presentation.
I'm Christina Ricker, and I am the sponsor for Leading Ladies. Leading Ladies is the girls' equivalent of Guys in Ties. I brought with me some of the gals that are in Leading Ladies. That are in fourth through sixth grade. We meet once a month. They dress up, and in the morning we come in, have pizza, and we discuss a topic. My mission, my mission with them is to create the opportunity for them in our elementary school to learn things that they need to make a positive impact on their school and their community. Lessons that we have covered so far this year: how to introduce yourself, how to write a note to a stranger. So with that, I had them make Valentine's Day cards for the residents over at the nursing home. How to give and accept a compliment, and cell phone manners. Topics that we'll cover so far, or in the future this year, self-care and hygiene, social media, and sports. I've been trying to get the girls out there in the community volunteering. They've read chapters for the Two Schools, One Book. They help out JPP with the concession stands and soup supper. And then we started going over to the nursing home on one Monday a month to go help the residents play bingo. Did you guys have any questions for us?
You do the bingo during the school day?
Nope, after school.
After school.
We leave 15 minutes early, but with the older grades, they usually have study hall during that time.
So give us your best compliment.
No, they accept compliments.
Oh, accept compliments.
Give and accept compliments. Oh, give and accept, okay, I'll give you the compliment, I'm impressed. Wonderful, thanks ladies for stepping up to the plate to lead our school in this, these ways.
Thank you very much.
So what time do you have to get to school when you have?
7:30.
Not too bad.
Thank you for leading them.
Yeah, well, my daughter Kylie, she said, why don't we have a girls' group? They have guys and ties, why don't we have a girls' group? So I brought it up and was asked to lead it, so thank you.
Very, very awesome.
Absolutely.
So do you wanna one-up the guys and ties? They did a presentation 2 months ago, do you wanna one-up them?
We already do one-up.
Yes. Yes. That's a confidence is also something they've been working on.
Yes, absolutely.
They went and introduced themselves to each board member, proper way to introduce yourself, and so they did do that. They didn't make great eye contact. So that would be one easy way you could do that.
No slideshow either, there was any slideshow.
They did not have a slideshow.
Mr. Peter kind of dropped it.
Go ahead, just go right, just you can start, right? Here with Dr. Thor, just go down the line.
I'm Kylie Richter.
I'm Jim, nice to meet you.
I'm Kim, yeah, I'm.
Nice to meet you.
Hi, Kim.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Yes.
Nice to meet you.
Of course.
Yeah, the most teaching we can't lie.
Great program, thanks for doing that for our school. Ladies.
Thanks, girls, very good.
Good leaders.
You're pretty good.
Thank you for coming, you can stay if you want.
I'm advised going.
I think the most exciting part of the evening is over.
Yeah, it's too nice to be here.
Thank you.
Okay, do we have any public comments tonight? Kelly raised her hand. No public comments?
I'll do one.
Ref back here.
I'll do one.
Oh, okay, alright.
Is that right? Acceptable?
Yeah.
Oh, we got it.
After a portion of our agenda set aside for public comment, each person wishing to address the board will be recognized by the board president. Also, each person wishing to address the board will be allowed only one opportunity to do so soon. We request that you limit your comments to 5 minutes or less, and we advise you on that 5 minute time period as elapsed. Please remember that this is a public meeting for the conduct of the business of the Plainview Public School District. Offensive language, personal attacks, and hostile conduct will not be tolerated. You should be further advised that there is no legal protection for any comments that are made. Go ahead, Brooke.
Just something I decided I was gonna do, so I'm just gonna keep doing it. In the Steen Block versus the Elkhorn Township Board from 1994, the court indicated, the Supreme Court indicated, that in a case involving allegations of violation of the open meeting statutes, an emergency is defined as any event or occasional combination of circumstances which calls for immediate action or remedy, pressing necessity, existency, a sudden or unexpected happening, an unforeseen occurrence or condition. That's it.
So is that pretty broad or is that pretty to the point? In your opinion?
Are you asking me?
Yeah.
Well, I didn't know you were, I didn't know.
Well, I am.
Usually we don't accept.
That's pretty broad.
Acknowledge or accept, I don't find that it's very broad in my opinion at all. It says exactly what it has to be.
Okay.
So.
Alright, thank you. Anybody else like to speak? Okay, move on to number 11, discussion items, board development. Court Service, page 96 to 101.
So this was with regard to the board's role related to employment matters, and obviously in the spring, starting about December, with superintendent's contract and then the principal's contract, and then your certified teacher contracts. So just thought it was this problem that could have maybe been a discussion or topic, you know, a few months back. But, nothing in here probably that would have been new to you or that you would have not been maybe aware of, but.
Yes, the one paragraph that hit me is on page 96, the last full paragraph there. It talks about why you don't get into conversations about, as a board, about certain topics that come up, because if they do go to due process, we are the jury. And if you know all the rumors and gossip about it before it ever goes to due process, you can't sit on the jury. So you have to be kind of picked a side already, I guess. So, I mean, that was kind of an important paragraph.
But again, this is just a suggestion, right?
That's not.
Well, that's not. I mean, that's fact. That's if it goes to due process, we are the jury. And if you already have made up your mind, just like being a jury for any other court case, you cannot sit on that jury if you already have your mind made up.
So we live in a community of like 1,200 people. How the heck are you supposed to not hear the rumors?
Well, you don't have a conversation. If somebody calls you, you don't have a conversation with them about it. You move them on to the right people. And yeah. You're going to hear. That's also why sometimes we're the last to know.
Very much so.
Yeah. It's frustrating, but yeah, that's why. Yeah. Yeah. So. Anybody else have anything they want to share on that? Hopefully we don't have to use a lot of this stuff ever. Okay, move on to action items. Number 12, discuss and take possible action on revision to policy 70202, budget planning, preparation, and schedules.
So this is just required language change by statute and procedure that I will have to follow. Nothing too dramatically different, even though there's a lot of strikeouts and additions. But it's just a statutory change to the planning and preparation of the budget, which will start to take place here pretty quick. So my budget form from the state auditor will be a little bit different. So we just download that from the state auditor, and it does most, you know, a lot of the calculation for you. But so a lot of these, some of this is just procedural and timing and certain bits of information and when those are provided. So it won't be anything that anybody will really recognize, but just statutory change for all four of those policies, actually.
It did make it 10 days later, from the 20th to the 30th.
Yeah. September 30th, yeah.
Okay, so I want to make a motion to approve this as well.
I'll make a motion to approve revisions to policy 70202, budget planning, preparation, schedules as read.
Is there a second?
Second.
It's been first and second, Deb?
Yes.
Thor?
Yes.
Myself, yes.
Yep.
Tim?
Yes.
Chance?
Yeah.
Motion carries 6-0. 13, discuss and take possible action on revision to policy 702.03, budget adoption process.
Policy 702.03, budget adoption process as read.
Second. second, and myself, yes, Wyatt?
Yes.
Tim?
Yes.
Chance?
Yes.
Dr. Thor?
Yes.
Jim?
Yes.
Motion carries 6-0. 14. Discuss and take possible action on revision to policy 204.10 on the agenda.
It indicates that the agenda will be placed on the website 24 hours in advance of board meeting.
I'll make a motion to approve the 14 in red agenda changes.
A second.
First and second, and Chance?
Yeah.
Tim?
Yes.
Wyatt?
Yes.
Dr. Thor?
Yes.
Jim?
Yes.
Myself, yes. Motion carries 6-0. 15, discuss and take possible action on revision to policy 204.11, meeting minutes. So it just states you don't wait until they're approved before you put them on immediately, right?
Yeah, minutes placed on the district website at such time as they are available and shall be there for 6 months. So usually within 48 hours, we've got the, Kelly and I have the minutes approved, so they're already on there. We're already doing this. But we just need to have proper language and policy.
First and second, Wyatt?
Yes.
Tim?
Yes.
Chance?
Yeah.
Tim?
Yes.
Dr. Thor? Myself, yes. Motion carries 6-0. Number 16, discuss and take possible action on offering a 1.0 FTE teaching contract to Abby Cush for the 2022-23 school year.
Do we ever do exit interviews for all these teachers that leave?
No, we've never.
How come we don't
put that into our policy?
Do you think maybe we should? Well, that's a lot of turnover. I had a couple parents call me concerned about it, I guess.
They would call me.
We talked about it a few years back and decided not to do that. I don't know for sure you guys remember why we decided not to.
Well, you can't basically even make them feel
right. Well, you can ask.
I've talked to
them. We don't have a direct relationship with the staff. I mean, that's not our job.
No.
That's the issue.
So what if there's a problem, though, that the reason all these people are leaving is because of something that's going on, and if we're not aware of the problem, how are we supposed to fix it?
I've talked to several people that are leaving, and they all have a variety of reasons, and good ones.
I've talked to a few that left, and their reasons aren't that great.
You'll always have that.
More than a few, actually. I just don't know why we don't do it, or at least ask. I mean, isn't that kind of our job to find out why they were leaving? Are we supposed to be looking out for better education for our kids?
It's our role as far as employment management is right there, page 96. Right there in the board development manual, right there. So if they were going to conduct an exit interview, it would be up to their administrators to do it. And they'll probably, correct me if I'm wrong, wouldn't that go into their employee file? We wouldn't be privy to that information anyway, would it?
Well, I mean, last year we had one teacher retire. Didn't have any teacher leave last year to take a job elsewhere. This year we happen to have a couple of teachers that are moving closer to home, young, single, teachers moving closer to home, a couple got married, husbands are being relocated, one's choosing to stay home with a child, a couple retirements, just it just happens. Some years you have one, Some years you have a higher percentage. This happens to be one of those years.
You're always gonna have some that they don't fit with the administration, they knock heads, and that's with any job, any group of people. So you're always gonna have some of that, people just aren't happy about the way things are run. That doesn't mean anybody's doing anything wrong, it's just personalities sometimes.
And I'm sure our administrators have had conversations with anyone once they turn in their letter of resignations anyway, right? It wasn't just they turn in a letter and they walk out the door and they say, I'm done.
If I was gonna say something bad to somebody, and if I was in charge of hearing that bad thing, I'm sure I'm gonna tell it to the people that are controlling me.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that makes no sense.
Well, they could contact, especially after they resign, they can contact the full board and let us know what their reason was too, if they're really upset and I think something's wrong here. Yeah. Obviously, you've heard some of that, but I have. I can't say I've heard. I mean, if we were all getting phone calls, I guess I'd be pretty concerned that they were pretty upset about what was going on. Well, I kind of got off subject here on what we're... She changed her major, right? She was science and now she's...
No, she...
She was science when she was here for a little bit and math.
And math, yeah. And she taught math. No, science in Dayton City and math in Grand Island. But back...
She was
nice to have her back in the community. So I'll make a motion to approve the policies on 1.0 with FTE certified contract to advocate for the 2022-2023 school year.
I'll second. Myself, yes. Wyatt?
Yes.
Tim?
Yes.
Chance?
Yeah.
Dr. Thorne?
Yes.
Kim?
Yes.
Motion carries 6-0. 17, discuss and take possible action on offering 1.0 FTE teaching contract to Taylor Oestrich?
Oestrich.
Oestrich? For the 2022-23 school year.
Okay, the married couple, 2-for-1, right?
Not 2-for-1, but...
But he will be the...
English teacher.
High school.
I'll make a motion to approve a 1.0 FTE certified contract with Taylor Oestrich for the 2022-2023 school year.
Second?
I'll second.
That's first and second. Dr. Thor?
Yes.
Chance?
Yes.
Tim?
Yes.
Wyatt?
Yes.
Myself, yes. Deb?
Yes.
Motion carries 6-0. Number 18, discuss and take possible action on offering 1.0 FTE teaching contract to Abby Simpson for the 2022-23 school year.
I'll make a motion to accept hire that. There's the word.
Number 17.
I'll make a motion to approve a 1.0 FTE certified contract for Abby Simpson for the 2022-2023 school year.
Second.
So first and second. Deb?
Yes.
Myself, yes. Wyatt?
Yes.
Kim?
Yes.
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 Yes. Motion carries 6-0. Number 19, discuss and take possible action on offering 1.0 FTE teaching contract to Trent Simpson for the 2022-23 school year. Number 20, discuss and take possible action on offering 1.0 FTE teaching contract to Sage Wortman for the 2022-23 school year.
I'll
Second. Dr. Thor?
Yes.
Jim?
Yes.
Chance?
Yes.
Jim?
Yes.
Wyatt?
Yes.
Myself, yes, motion carries 6-0. Number 21. We need to do this one? Staff resignation?
Yes, you have.
Discuss and take possible action on accepting certified staff resignation.
Yes, you have three in there. So you'll just need to accept each one individually. So, Taylor Hitz?
Yes.
So you just need a motion in a second to accept her resignation at the end of the school year.
Do we have to do them separately?
Yes.
I'll make a motion to accept the resignation of Taylor Hitz effective at the end of the 2021-2022 school year.
Second?
Second.
First and second. Wyatt?
Yes.
Myself, yes. Deb?
Yes.
Dr. Thor?
Yes.
Chance?
Yes.
Tim?
Yes.
Motion carries 6-0.
Katie Wobbs?
I'll make a motion to accept the resignation of Katie Wobbs effective at the end of 2021-2022 school year.
I'll second. Chance?
Yes.
Dr. Thor?
Yes.
Jim?
Yes.
Myself, yes. Wyatt?
Yes.
Tim?
Yes.
Motion carries 6-0.
Anybody want to do the next one? You want me to just keep
you're
on?
Doing good.
You're good.
You're on a roll.
I'll make a motion to accept the resignation of Caitlin Knox effective at the end of the 2021-2022 school year.
Second?
I'll second.
First and second, Tim?
Yes.
Chance?
Yes.
Dr. Thor?
Yes.
Deb?
Yes.
Wyatt?
Yes.
Myself, yes. Motion carries 6-0.
That's when her married name, though.
Kate Carlson.
Yeah.
And doesn't she go by? Do we need to be careful of that or not?
It's not signed either.
It's just because she hasn't changed her name yet for Social Security. That's why I still feel
the
same way. I'm
okay.
Pretty
well,
particular about that.
It's the opposite.
It's probably what her contract says, too.
It could be.
Okay.
Yeah, she got married in December.
Okay, number 22, number 23. Discuss and take possible action on purchasing an updated 712 math book materials for $23,613.04.
Been talking about this for a couple of years. Kyle and Heather before Jen started working with the team, and then Jen picked that up with her team this last year. So these are two pretty significant resource adoptions that we don't really want to have happen in the same cycle. But I think we put one off because of COVID. There was a reason that we delayed one. I think math we delayed. So they're at the same time. So I mean, we'll just budget for it. But they've been thoroughly vetted by our team, and these are their recommendations. It's time for update resources in both math and language arts.
So one of the, I think it was it a policy or the fundamentals? I think it was policy. You're supposed to review all your curriculum every 7 years.
Saxon's been there. I taught Saxon.
Yeah. And review doesn't mean that you replace it, but however.
It's a budgeted item that we plan on.
It's not something come out.
No, no.
We had a spreadsheet put in front of us, I believe.
Yeah,
a year ago or two, maybe 2 years ago.
Yeah.
Anyway, so. Yep. All right. I'll make a motion to approve the request for new math materials for high school in the amount of $23,613.04.
I'll second that.
It's been first and second. Myself, yes. Deb?
Yes.
Dr. Thor?
Yes.
Wyatt?
Yes.
Yes.
Chance?
Yes.
Motion carries 6-0. 24, discuss and take possible action on purchasing updated K-6 math materials for $45,413.83.
I'll make a motion to approve the request for new math materials for the elementary in the amount of $45,413.83.
First and seconded. Wyatt?
Yes.
Tim?
Yes.
Stewart?
Yes.
Myself, yes, motion carries 6-0. Number 25, discuss and take possible action on purchasing a used 71 passenger bus for $57,900.
It's still the same one you want, Bob?
Yeah.
I know, checked on different places, and that looks like the best one available to us at this point. So.
What year is it?
It is a 2016. And it was the same price as the 17. There was about 3,000 miles difference on it, but the 16 does have air conditioning in it too for an activity bus that seems to be nice.
Russian?
No.
71 passenger, you'd think so.
It is coming out of the south, so it probably hasn't run on the salted roads like the northern ones. That's another deal. A lot of northern ones don't have the AC in them. It's supposedly in Branson right now. It was used in Louisiana. And I guess they're gonna.
But when we leaving for Branson?
They will deliver, they said. So.
Well, that's not fun.
There you go. Here's some of our vacations.
So is that a diesel or gas?
Diesel.
Diesel with the hydraulic brakes, not air brakes?
Yes. If you go 72 passenger, you're required to have air brakes in the bus. 71, you are not. So if you cut that short chunk off, that's even better. It makes a difference if you don't have air brakes.
And it's the shopping that we've been doing a little bit, and I've gone to a couple of conferences, and of course, there are vendors there. And I mean, I always start with, when we start talking about them, I said, I want to put kids on it and drive it in Nebraska the day after I buy it. So don't talk to me about something that's not, because every state's a little different. These buses could come from any state. So Bob, you know, made sure that I knew, you know, the right questions to ask. So it's been almost a year since we lost that big bus. We got that settlement for it. Initially, we started. I'm glad we held off. You know, we could have bought. You know, I think last summer we were looking at possibly buying a bus or two, cheap, real cheap ones. You know, and so this would probably be a pretty good long-term solution. Obviously, it's cost more than what we were looking at last summer, and certainly well over the settlement that we got. But what did we pay 5 years ago, Bob? We bought a 58 passenger 5 years ago for close to 80.
It was 82 or 83,000 on that one. They say you're about 2 years out on a new one at this point.
What would this be?
This one, I don't know, 59 would be right at the 100,000 mark now. A new one.
So is this one still got the DEF on it, or did somebody delete it?
This one being a 16, I don't think it will have the DEF on it.
You have luggage storage? Those compartments?
No. We could not find anything with that on it.
Okay.
Yeah, we have luggage storage.
Yeah.
It's a cab over type.
This is a regular conventional bus.
Conventional.
Yeah.
It's not like that.
No,
well, the steps aren't out in front of the wheels, you know, the total without
that. How long is the thing?
It's going to be two rows of seats longer than what we have right now. 59, so you gain 12 on it by adding two more rows of seats in.
Three little kindergartners per seat. So it's never going to carry 71 bodies.
Does it have racks on the inside of the bus?
No, it does not.
Something with the best buy.
Does it have a hitch on it so you can pull the trailer behind the bus?
That is illegal.
That's illegal. Yes, it doesn't, but.
Because you might have them kids on in that trailer that you don't want in the bus.
Sound allergies.
You just put a door
in. Thank God they didn't have a trailer when I wrote.
So it'll be here yet for a week or two, or
Well, I told him tonight was the board meeting, and they've kinda got it locked to us as long as it's okay. If not, it's back open. They said they're moving fairly fast because the new ones are 2 years out to get.
We'll have it for this year, use it this year for track or whatever.
They gotta get, if we get it, he's gotta bring it in, put the lettering on it, and then they need some reflective strips on the bumper on it that Nebraska requires.
Well, don't let Shu be the first one to drive it.
Ready for a motion?
I'm ready.
Okay, I'll make a motion to approve purchase of a used bus in the amount of $57,900.
I'll second. Yeah, it's been first and second, myself, yes, Deb.
Yes.
So, Chance?
Yes.
Tim?
Yes.
Wyatt?
Yes.
Motion carries 6-0. All right, we're on to reports, activity director's report.
We hosted our track invitational, first day of April. If you were there, it went pretty well. We had 13 teams there, 14 teams. And we were done and out of there by 6 o'clock, I believe, 6:30, so. We had electronic timing system. We are gonna host districts this year, so we have to do that. But it made things go pretty well. And not having school that day and having people run events was very beneficial, so hopefully we can do that again for district track to get everything lined up, so it runs as smooth as it did this time. So with that, spring sports are underway. Golf finally got going last week. Took them a while. They missed out on the first few events, but and then track got going last week as well. All-star game participants piece is going to be playing in the North Central Nebraska All-Star game that's in O'Neill. So that's a pretty good honor to have somebody playing in that. And then Will is gonna play in the Northeast Nebraska All-Star game. So that'll be in North Fork on June 11th. I think Pieces is on the 27th. Is that right?
That's right, yeah.
May 27th in O'Neill.
Aren't you coaching? Are you coaching the red white game too?
Coach Peter and I are coaching in the red white game. So,
yay.
Yep. So that's about it for activities. It's going to be wild here for the next few weeks. A lot of stuff going on. So
I just won't. I don't want to slam anybody, but how does a kid that was hurt half the season get to the All-Star game? And he got busted with marijuana. I'm just asking, like, who votes on that? Are the coaches submit that? Or?
I nominate them. And so I nominated both my seniors. And then as a coaching staff, we get together and we select kids. And we pick who we take on to the team.
A couple other coaches on with you, isn't there, from other schools?
There were six of us that all got together. But I also look at the accumulation over a career and knowing that a kid got to miss out on an entire senior year of football season because of an injury and that still showed up every single day to practice and didn't skip anything, came to every single game, didn't skip anything, and had a great attitude the whole time. So that, to me, said a lot more than a lot of other things because we all make dumbass mistakes. And I hope he learned from it.
I just wondered how they got there.
And congratulations on being a coach.
Thank you.
That's
exciting.
Awesome.
I heard you on the radio the first day it came out. It said Coach Schmidt was going to be the coach for the red team or the white team? White?
White.
All right, thank you for that. Move on to the
principal's
report.
Work-based learning. I was getting some feedback. I sent you guys PDFs of stuff. Actually, I sent you Google Sheets, and then Mr. Souser asked me to send out a different version. So I just got done sending you PDFs of all of it. But that's responses coming back from parents, students, businesses. We had four businesses get back to us. Frontier did, Custom Sports did. Who was the other one? North Fork Fire and Rescue, and then Wilbur Ellis. And all four businesses said that it's been a great program, and the kids have been working really well, been responsible on time, haven't missed things of that sort. Parents liked the program so far, the overall consensus. I did have one parent that would have liked to have been a part of the meeting where we have the student and the business owner together, just so they could meet them and stuff like that. That was one parent who didn't know the person. A lot of local businesses, they already know them, so that was just something that, looking back at, could be something to change. But other than that, it's been pretty much positive feedback from everything, so. But you can read through that, and if you have questions, let me know.
Are all the kids getting paid, or is it only certain, is that up to the business, or how does that work?
It's up to the business. So when we go into it, we have the assumption that kids aren't gonna get paid for doing it. And when I talk to the businesses, I don't expect them to be paid or anything like that. But like in Norfolk, I know Custom Sports did, just saying that if you're gonna drive to town, we wanna reimburse you at least for your fuel and stuff like that. So there are a few that do.
I think that makes any difference to the kids, whether they get paid or not, as to whether or not, what
it doesn't seem to, talking to them and stuff. I think they find it, you know, as kind of a privilege to get paid, but it doesn't really sway their decision of what they're gonna do. I actually just sent out a survey to our juniors yesterday, I believe it was. It was today. And asking them kind of what they want to do. And there's a few kids that want to go into education and are looking at shadowing teachers and stuff like that. So there's a few different positions where that wouldn't be an option. So.
Are you still thinking of doing it all year, next year, or your half a semester? I know there were some comments the kids that said that they might prefer to half a semester.
There was two kids that said that they didn't know if the whole year would be what they want to do. The problem comes in with who wants to take the class, because through Northeast, if you're going to take a college class, then that's going to last the full year. So that's what we're trying to get some feedback to figure out, how many of them are actually going to take a class, and then we can bring that to you guys and let you know.
So could they switch, like, between semesters, switch jobs, trainings?
Mm-hmm. We actually had, I know one for sure that switched halfway through. I want to say we had two. I know Emma King switched halfway through and went from doing nursing to cosmetology. So normally we want them to do it for 8 weeks before we switch, but that's just kind of, want to make sure they give it a full try before they actually make a decision and change.
Did everybody get matched up, or was there something that didn't get?
So we had a few kids that are seniors right now that we didn't match up. Some of them had to meet requirements to graduate, and so that's what we kept them in school for. And then there were some that it just took a long time to get placed. I know we just got one placed here a couple weeks ago, so those were a couple of things that took a while.
So does that help you out with the kids that need a little extra help then to meet graduation requirements, and they get a little more one-on-one because most of the kids are going?
They get one-on-one time during that, but also if they had to make up a class because they failed one or something, we also allow them to do APEX on those days and earn those credits back. So then it helps them so they can get that made up and done before having to take summer school.
So if you do it the full year next year, are you going to encourage kids to maybe look at two different things and switch like a semester, or?
From the feedback that I've got quite a few kids that are looking at two different areas, so that probably would be something that I would look at, say, hey, let's do this one for the first semester, second semester, come in and try this one, and get that squared away, so that way they're able to see both.
And then turn into summer jobs?
Trevor's, I believe, is. Dor got a, he got a CDL right before that went up, an astronomical amount to be able to do that. So he's doing stuff for Wilbur Ellis, and I know he's going to be doing stuff there. Derek Ricks is already enrolled in flight school in Omaha, and his is going to turn into, he's going to work out there over the summer, fueling planes and doing that kind of stuff in Norfolk. So there's a few of them that have. There's a couple of them that said, this is not what I thought it was, and I want to change and do something else. Brittany Gutz was one of those. She wanted to go into occupational therapy and now wants to do physical therapy. So.
It sounds like it helped. help them make some decisions as to what they want to do.
Maybe save them a bunch of money too.
So that's kind of where that's at with everything.
We have filled the two positions in the elementary. So one of those two teachers is our ESSER funded teacher, and then the other one is the full-time teacher that we're replacing. Our evacuation, so the reunification that we had planned for months went fabulous. Elementary line seemed to take a little longer than the high school, but great feedback from people that were patiently waiting and moving through. I mean, in an actual evacuation, I don't think we're gonna have mobs of people all in line waiting, so it'll be a little different, but for the most part, I mean, the planning that we did went really well, and we felt very good about it after the fact. So we feel very prepared if we were ever to have to deal with that. JPP, so our pledge-a-thon that we spent 2 weeks the end of March raised over $8,000. Super excited about that. We, up to date, have collected over $21,000 this year for the playground. So we are thrilled about that. Ms. Christina and I filled out paperwork and applied for a Keno grant with the city, and they will vote on that tomorrow night, so she's going to go on behalf of the JPP for that. Testing, we are both testing in our buildings, and the intent is to have it done by next week, if not this week yet, but that includes our state and district testing that we're doing. And up to this point, it's gone very well. We tried a different method of testing for our MAP testing, and both of us are testing all students at the same time, Thursday mornings for 2 hours, and it's night and day difference compared to what the amount of time that we had committed to doing this in the past. So super excited about that, and kids are liking that as well. Field trips, they start Wednesday, so the fourth graders head out on Wednesday to Lincoln, and the rest of the elementary classes are all planned. Even sixth grade will happen in May, so all of those are scheduled and will be happening in the next month and a half as well.
Can I ask a question about the evacuation thing?
Yeah.
How come, I know, I get it that the bus is in, how come the handyman still was able to go?
Because it's a regular vehicle that picks up our kids every day.
But isn't the bus a regular vehicle that picks up kids every day?
But these are parents that seek that service out, and so.
Through the city.
It's more a private deal than a school deal.
Yeah.
I see. I just wonder, because I just thought
we don't, the school doesn't pay for the minivan at all.
You did too.
Yeah.
We don't fund that.
Mm-hmm.
So that let you know that the kids are getting on.
Correct. And we have regular riders, so. But yes, that would be something that would be communicated to us.
And then, what's the reason for not letting kids that are driving ages take their vehicle and leave? The people that have like a high schooler and also an elementary kid, why can't the, or a big brother grab the little sister or whatever? I'm just asking, because I don't know.
That's still essentially parents knowing where their kids are, because in the event that we're doing this, it's a matter of making sure that kids get to their parents. And so they're still considered minors. I understand we have a few seniors that may be 18, but that's going to be a very small amount. And so that's why we do that.
And I think the other thing, Chance, is we are not on school property when that happens, so just to send a high schooler to walk to their car to get home, I mean, that's why we didn't even let elementary kids walk if their house was a block or two away, just to make sure that they were accounted for.
Interesting liability if your little kid went missing or they didn't know where it was at, because, oh, somebody went to take them home.
Well, the one thing I thought of is if there was actually an active shooter or something, the Dodge wouldn't have been patiently waiting in line. It'd have been parked in this building or wherever this guy was at.
So, for you, the people.
Yeah. And trust me, I always have weapons with me. So. But no, I thought it was a good idea. But I just was wondering about the handyman thing, because I thought it was odd that the bus couldn't run with the handyman. A
couple of school improvement updates for you. PBIS, we've had our MTSS team working on some common language K-12 for behaviors. And so that team's been meeting to kind of give Jen and I an idea of what we want to build. So our behavior plan looks the same, K-12. Obviously, there's going to be differences between the elementary and high school, but we want to use some common language and have some familiarity between the two buildings. So that's what that group's working on. Obviously, resources for teachers. We've brought up math. That's been approved. We'll have English coming here next month. And then they've all been working on curriculum updates and pacing guides to make sure state standards are being met. And then here at the end of the month and the beginning of May, our data team's going to be working on plugging in all of our testing scores and stuff and seeing our growth and our longevity over the last couple of years. So that's kind of where we're at with our school improvement.
So when do you get the results back of these tests you're doing now? Will you get them back before the end of this year or not until next year?
The map data we get instantly.
Oh, it is?
Yep. And numbers, the numbers are what kids are motivated by. I mean, that's
sure.
Every test they take, they're like, does it give us our number? State tests, however, we do not get results until the fall.
And that's when they give you the official ones. You can get unofficial results right now. Because
mm-hmm.
we can go in and get a map score, essentially, so that way we can compare it to what their fall and winter were. But we won't get the official scores from the state until this fall.
Do they vary a lot?
Depends, because like right now it's based off of the average of the United States, and so what happens is once all the scores come in, they'll it's essentially kind of like scaling a test or whatever based on that.
But gives you enough time to make adjustments for next year if you get the results.
Yeah.
Anybody have any more questions? Thank you, too, for your info. I don't have anything for president report, so hold on.
I guess I would make a comment maybe about the idea of an exit interview. The closest thing we have is probably the teacher's resignation letters. So just read those. Just read them. Read the language that's in them. If there was a systemic administrative issue, a lot of them would just say, I quit. So read the language in those. And, you know, if you have folks that they're sure not gonna say, I've appreciated the support of the administrative team. I have thoroughly enjoyed my time here and have honored a chance to work with. I have brought great joy. It's brought me great joy to work with the kids at Plainview Public Schools. Joyful, memorable, and rewarding career. Thank you for taking a chance on me. I'm grateful for your support. Probably not gonna say those things. Okay, so have whoever this might be that is calling you, have them call the school. Okay, we won't have school on May 11th. That's going to be district track.
12.
May 12th. We won't have school on Thursday, May 12th. We'll have a district track meet. It'll be a wonderful event down at our nice new track. So there'll be no study and contract day. But we won't have students that day. Just some budgetary information, essentially, you know, and some of the teachers that are retiring or moving are 60 plus thousand teachers. We've hired several teachers that'll be BA Step 3, which is where we start those teachers. So we have about $125,000 differential right now to the positive in what our certified contracts or certified salaries will be next year. Jen had alluded to the evac drill. We will probably do that. We'll likely maybe do that once a year at the most. We're not required to have a minimum number of evac reunification drills as we are fire drills or tornado drills. Jen and Kyle did excellent work at the reunification places to try to keep things moving well. So,
who decides like whether you need to get everybody out of school or whether you need to lock down state school? Does that come from the police force?
That would come from us based on information that we would get from a local emergency source. Yeah. So they actually can't, an outside source actually can't put us in lockdown, but they receive essentially the same standard response emergency protocol training that we do, that we receive. In fact, we'll have a law enforcement official in here in August to train us on standard response protocol for safety training. So that's essentially an administrative decision based on information from emergency personnel. We took care of your transportation fleet. There's your enrollment summary. Had two meetings out of district. Sick balance update, that should be 45.5, not 47. Okay, and that's all I have for you.
You're able to get bus drivers to go to class?
Say that again, for our field trip?
You're able to get the bus drivers to drive the buses for that kind of stuff?
Yeah, we have to pick dates where there's not already a bunch of school activities, but yep, we've put them all with Bob, so we're okay.
Okay, is there anybody else?